Well, we had a wonderful presentation from one of the real experts in neoadjuvant therapy today. Her name's Mary Ellen Taplin. And she has led a number of the neoadjuvant trials. And for many years, the concept of treating patients who have high-risk prostate cancer with therapy before surgery has been attractive to us. And there is a series of clinical trials where patients got androgen deprivation therapy before radical prostatectomy. And it pretty universally would cause a shrinking of the cancer, often more negative surgical margins. But when we looked at 3 and 5 year PSA recurrence rates, unfortunately it was about the same. So that fell out of common practice. What Mary Ellen and her group at Dana-Farber did is use our new, very strong androgen deprivation tools, abiraterone acetate and enzalutamide, to treat people with those drugs plus LHRH agonists, standard hormonal therapy, before radical prostatectomy. And what she showed us was a significant number of the patients treated with abiraterone have very small tumors at radical prostatectomy, or the tumor's gone at radical prostatectomy. And the patients who have this really profound response to neoadjuvant therapy, that seems to correlate with having a good outcome long term. So that's exciting. And you can imagine a man who has a screening PSA, he's in his 50s, the PSA comes back 50, the biopsy shows Gleason 4+5 prostate cancer. It's very bad news, his recurrence risk is high. He's asking us, what can I do to potentially improve my outcome? And so off study, giving that kind of therapy, you know, is not recommended because we haven't proven its efficacy. But I think Dr. Taplin's studies and others are really exciting, and this field's moving. So we'll be using more neoadjuvant, abiraterone, docetaxel, certainly those drugs and others in clinical trials. It's also a great clinical trial model, because we have the radical prostatectomy as a measurement of response. So I think it's that model, the neoadjuvant model, is a great model to test the effectiveness of prostate cancer drugs when it's safe.